So this is an example of a factor ring. It is a factor group as well, which makes sense. I mean, if this is going to be a ring, that does also mean it's got to be a group under addition. Z is the integers. 4z represents all the multiples of 4. 4z consists of all multiples of 4, both as a cyclic subgroup generated by 4 of the integers. And also it is the principal ideal generated by 4. You could write it this way too. It's super closed. If you multiply 4 by any integer, you still get a multiple of 4. It is ultimately then an ideal, so we can form the factor ring. That's the content of the theorem above the example. And you define the factor ring addition and multiplication by adding or multiplying representatives of the cosets, the 0, the 1, the 2, the 3. And then you do need to use properties of cosets from chapter 7 to simplify these things. So the example done in the book, let's work through it, is to take 2 plus 4z, that left coset, first and add 3 plus 4z. We will also multiply them. This first step is the definition of coset addition as a group operation from chapter 9. You add cosets by adding their representatives. That's the definition of the group operation in this factor ring. Definition of the group operation in the factor ring Z mod 4Z. You could think of it as the group operation in the factor group. Add cosets by adding representatives. The next step is just, well, the fact that 2 plus 3 equals 5. The next step is using properties of cosets. It's a couple different ways it could be thought about. Here's the way the book thinks of it. Think of 5 as 1 plus 4, like this. Then think of that as 1 plus, think of the 4 as getting sucked into the 4z. Essentially, what we're using there is this coset property, AH equals H if and only if A is an H. Technically, we're also using the fact that ABH is the same as ABH. We're technically also using that fact too, to know that we can just keep the one there as well. But we're using it with addition instead of multiplication. AH equals H if and only if A is an H. 4 plus 4Z, that thing right there, is the same as 4Z because 4 is in 4Z. 4z is the h. So it simplifies to this coset. Another way to think of this, to realize these are the same, is to think about what the elements of this thing are. The elements of 1 plus 4z are all multiples of 4 plus 1. So that would include negative 7, negative 3, positive 1, positive 5, positive 9, positive 13, etc. And that set does include 5. So either 5 or 1 could be thought of as representatives for this coset. So could 9, so could 13, so could negative 3, so could negative 7. So there's a couple ways you could justify that step to say these are equal. You can either do this, that's what the book does, or do what I just said. As far as multiplication goes now in this factor ring, we still write the cosets with the additive notation. With factor rings, you always write your cosets with plus signs, because the group operation of the factor ring is addition. always. Because rings themselves always have an addition. So we're taking 2 plus 4z and multiplying by 3 plus 4z. According to that theorem above the example again, you multiply cosets by multiplying their representatives. You don't do the FOIL method or anything like that. You know, there's not going to be any 16z squareds, if that's ever confusing. You only multiply the 2 and the 3 here. 2 times 3 plus 4z. Of course, that's 6 plus 4z. That first step is the definition of the multiplication in the factoring, which is not a group operation, it's the multiplication. It's associative and the distributive property holds, but it's not necessarily a group operation. Could be, but not necessarily. If we exclude zero, at least it could be. And then you simplify this in the same kind of way you simplify that. Write 6 as 2 plus 4. And then the 4 ultimately gets sucked into the 4z. This is the same as 2 plus 4z. These operations, and we could do more examples to verify this, are very similar to the fact that 2 plus 3 equals 5, mod 4 is 1, and 2 times 3 equals 6, mod 4 is 2. Is that a coincidence? No. The factor ring, z mod 4z, is ring isomorphic to Z4. These are ring isomorphic. There's a concept of ring isomorphism. There's also a concept of ring homomorphism. It's the next chapter, chapter 15. Very similar to group isomorphisms and group homomorphisms. The main difference is the operation preserving property has to work for both addition and multiplication. 4 is not prime. Z4 is not an integral domain because 4 is not prime. In particular, for example, 2 times 2 is 0 in Z4. Does that mean 2 plus 4z times 2 plus 4z also equals 0 in here? Yeah, it does. You'd multiply the ring representatives. 2 times 2 is 4. And then the 4 gets sucked in. And that is the identity, or the additive identity of the factor ring. It's the 0. 0 plus the ideal is the additive identity of the factor ring. The 0.